Meow, meow, meow.
The car is like a little jackal. It gives a meow. Look at the little flip. Look at the little cutest little flips. Are. Meow, meow. Oh, don't. No.
Full disclosure, I don't play fighting games. I don't know anything about them. So keep in mind that this review comes from someone with almost no understanding of those kinds of games. The first thing that I'll say is that Pokken Tournament looks good. It's probably the best looking Pokemon related game out there. I was a little bit concerned about how these Pokemon would make the transition into more realistic looking high definition graphics, but for the most part I think they turned out pretty good. The graphics and animations seem very smooth and polished, and overall I didn't notice any bugs or anything weird. Now other than Smash Brothers, any fighting game I've ever played always felt like there was just something I didn't understand. There's always been something about memorizing the complex button inputs that I never seemed to be able to pull off. But Pokken Tournament instantly felt more accessible than pretty much any other fighting game I've ever played, other than the aforementioned Super Smash Bros. The controls are extremely simple, most moves just being a single button or a combination of a button and a direction. I didn't feel overwhelmed trying to memorize some complex series of moves. I have a feeling that the easy attack system alone will push away some of the more serious or competitive fighting gamers, but I didn't find the game to lack depth overall. You basically make your own combos, and the game is more about spacing and reaction time. There's also a support Pokemon mechanic and a burst meter, and knowing when to use these plays a big part as well. Though I did find that the burst moves, while easy to pull off, are actually pretty hard to land.
I'm gonna miss again. I jumped in the air when you did it.
But I fuck!
My opponent easily avoided them most of the time. Though that made actually landing a burst move more exciting.
It didn't fucking work. Hey, fuck you. I can skill you too. I can skill you too! Outskilled, Matt. Out fucking matched.
I have a feeling that a big part of the game is meant to be setting up your opponent so you can hit them with a burst. The game also has a sort of rock, paper, scissors mechanic in that normal attacks beat grabs, grabs beat counters, and counters beat normal attacks. Though I found that most of the time, it doesn't seem to work as explained. I found my grabs getting countered quite a bit, and I'm not exactly sure why.
Oh my god! Oh my god! I've grabbed like two or three times and didn't fucking work. Tutorial fucking lied to me.
I also found the phase shifting mechanic a little bit cumbersome. Basically, there are two modes while you play, a more zoomed out 3D mode where you can run in all directions, and a more 2D mode where the game plays more like a traditional fighter. Using certain moves or combos will put you into these phases, but I couldn't explain to you exactly which one does what. For the most part, I just didn't worry about it and just played as though it didn't exist. When playing locally, one player looks at the TV and the other uses the screen on the Wii U controller. This was actually a pretty good use of the controller, and it made the whole shifting phases thing work a little bit better. But it did take a bit of getting used to resisting the urge to watch the TV instead of the controller.
Wait, I didn't pick Suikun, I was Blaziken.
No, you're Suikun. I was Blaziken. You keep looking at the wrong screen,
God
you retard.
Damn it!
You're the one, remember? Have an Aurora Beam.
Oh, I fucked it up!
What I did find a little odd were the voices of some of the Pokemon. Many of them sound very manly and strangely human. It's jarring hearing some of these noises come out of Pokemon.
God, this Suikun has such a weird, like, manly voice. Isn't that odd?
So does Blaziken.
Yeah, it's fucking weird. It's, like, traditionally seen as, like, feminine Pokemon.
Maybe you just watch too much fucking furry porn of them.
Dude, that is a false... Don't accuse me of such things.
Yeah.
I also found the game's roster to be a little bit weird. Most of the characters fit, like Machamp, Blaziken, or Lucario. They all have a more human shape and the way they fight makes sense, but some choices are very odd, Chandelure in particular. I'm not exactly sure how these fighters were chosen, but Chandelure can't be a very popular Pokemon, and its body style doesn't really fit the game. I also found it odd that there's a Pikachu and then a Luchador Pikachu. And these are two separate characters, instead of the Luchador just being a costume for Pikachu. The roster also seems very small at only 16 characters. With the vast amount of Pokemon there are, and so many of them having pre-established personality traits and fighting styles, I find it very odd that the roster is as small as it is. I have a feeling that Nintendo will be releasing more characters as paid DLC, or likely amiibos that you'll have to buy to unlock those characters. Though I've only played it for a few hours, overall I would recommend Pokken Tournament. It's very easy to get into and at the same time feels like it has a lot of depth. After playing it for the short time I did, I felt like there's a lot more I could learn about each character's movesets and spacing and the game mechanics in general. And I think that says something about the game's competitive potential. In case you're wondering, there is a single player mode, training mode, and both online and local multiplayer modes, so the game seems to come with what you would expect from a typical fighting game. If you are a fan of Pokemon and don't mind potentially paying more money for future characters, I would recommend picking the game up. Anyway, I'm Kothorix, and you have a wonderful day.